Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare
Shantakaram Bhujagasayanam Paddanavam Suresham Lakshmikantam Kamalanayanam Yogi Bidhyanagamam Bande Vishnu Bhavavayaharanam Saravalokoikanatham Saravalokoikanatham
Sampraday Vihinaje Mantraha Te Nisphala Mataha Sampraday Vihina Je Mantraha Te Nisphala Mataha Gauriya Goshtipati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur told that the actual identity of a Sadguru, the actual identity of a Sadguru is his unique or exclusive Hari Bhajan. What is the identity of an actual sadhu, actual guru, sadguru? Prabhupada speaking, that actually all is unique bhajan. All the 24 hours, Prabhupada told, all the 24 hours, a sadguru acharya always engage in bhajan. His exclusive bhajan is his identity. Follow what I say. All the time, 24 hours, he is always busy in Krishna Bhajan. That is his identity. Actually, I already told yesterday, there are four authentic sampradayas approved by Supreme Lord. Not only approved, he already sent some messenger. I already told yesterday about that. That by the desire of Supreme Lord, we have four authentic sampradaya in this world. Four authentic sampradaya approved by Supreme Lord. And it's a very important thing. Without any linkage with this, any of these three, four sampradaya, without any linkage, any shammanda, with any of these four sampradayas, you cannot do actual bhajan. You can try, but actual bhajan is not possible. Why? Why not possible? This kind of discrimination we should not say. No, not that actually. This not actually, it is not discrimination. It's a point of power. Suppose you have this light is on now. If the you know main switch is off, you have no connection, how you can get your light on? If the main, I mean there in the center, power center, if there is switch off, you cannot get any power. So you should have connection with that main power station. That is called transcendental power station, which is coming from there. Perhaps you can feel, if you hear Harikatha sometime, if you hear Harikatha, you can feel that Harikatha is not like a ordinary katha. It seems that sadhu has some connection with the transcendental linkage, tower connection. That's why Harikatha coming like flood. You can feel. That's why I told many times, Jiva Goswami Pada in Sandarbha told, you can remember, many times I told, Bhakta Sarago Nirago Divido Parikirtita. Bhakta means speaker, two times speaker. One having no desire inside heart, clean. You give something, not give something, nothing, you care little. Only for your benefit to help you to get the Kripa of Supreme Lord is speaking Harikatha. To deliver all common people, bonded soul, is this motto, resolution. In my whole life, I may try to save them all, those who are running behind Maya. I can take them away, take in my lap and say, my son, where you are going? My daughter, where you are going? It's not good. You come here, do bhajan properly. This is the mood of a pure Vaishnava. I mean, Vaishnava is full of compassion, but ordinary people misunderstand him. They say he is merciless, the thing I already told you. Actually, four sampradaya linkage is a must, and I already told we have connection with Madhya Sampradaya, that's why we have connection with Madhya Sampradaya. We have connection with Madhya Sampradaya. That's why we can say safely that we belong to Madhya Gauriya Sampradaya. There is no doubt in it. Be Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, all Guru Varga, Baldev Vidya Avashanji, everybody speaking this way. Now, actually, point is that somebody can think that you have some prejudicial idea. Why you speak this way? You should not speak this way. That without sampradaya we cannot do bhajan. Sampradaya, this word is an actually conservative attitude. Some people fighting. Some people, they want to prove that we are more liberal. You see, we are big sadhu. We have no such, you know, narrow conception. So you are free. It's one kind of cheating procedure. Be careful. Those who are speaking this way, they are number one cheater. Why? Those are speaking, Maharaj, we are not in any party. We are neutral party. Neutral party means also one kind of party. You say you are neutral party. Neutral party means you are also one kind of party. Follow what I say. Neutral party mean, what do you mean? Neutral party, you also, you one kind of party. So you are very clever, you should not speak this way. Actually, sampradaya, this word, if I split up this word as per Sanskrit grammar, it comes this way, sampradagha. Sampradagha, they split up in Sanskrit. That means, sam means sammak, completely, pro meaning to give, provide. This way, this meaning coming, that to give completely, intact way, the sampradayik power, sampradayik karuna, kripa, siddhanta, or power, intact way, if you like to transfer to a new devotee, sampradaya is a must. Sampradaya, this word doesn't mean, is one kind of conservative way. Just follow what I say. Sampradaya is, this word is not conservative word. It's very nice. Anyway, if you like to, you know, if you like to get the flow of your hereditary teaching in a nice way, intact way, then you must give some safeguard. Is guard? Through which this channel you can expect this in a shiksha, the teaching or bhakti can go flow, have some special teaching, special siddhanta, exclusive. So sampradaya, this word is not at all a conservative attitude. Anybody like to get his teaching, I mean shiksha or power flow in a very intact way, it is a must. To get control over this procedure and the flowing system. This controlling system, flowing system, is called sampradaya. You are giving a barrier so that you can get the teachings very in a flawless way. You can, no infiltration. No infiltration, no contamination. You like to protect your sikha very nice way through a channel. It's called sampradaya. Follow? Sham mean completely. Pro mean pradhan, to give the teaching. This is called sampradaya. So we cannot obey the conception of these foolish people, those who like to prove that we are more and more liberal. You see, not that. They are very clever. So this way, actually, today we get clear conception about sampradayic flow. So we already deserve, we already have document that we belong to Madhva Gauriya Sampradaya. Somebody like to prove that from the time of Baldev Vidyabhushan, it was the technique of Baldev Vidyabhushan that somehow he wanted to get a linkage with that Madhvacharya. Not that. Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada, oh, everybody speaking. Not that. Not that actually. I already told Madhvacharya came here, Ramanuja Jojo came here, Nimbarka Jojo came here, and Navadip, Vishnu Swami, all four Acharyas came here. Somehow they are enjoying the kippa of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, but the special kippa was there with Madhvacharya. Where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, golden complexion, appear in front of Madhvacharya and bless him, Acharya, I like to approve you, your Sampradaya. And this is not false conception. I already told Madhvacharya already getting the full kripa of Vyasadeva. Eh? Vyasadeva is the Saktavis avatar of Supreme Lord. Whereas Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Supreme Lord himself. So what wrong in it? Madhvacharya getting full kripa of Vyasadeva. Follow. Vyasadeva enjoying full kripa of Vyasadeva. So we are, you know, very much, you know, optimistic that our Acharya guiding us right way. We cannot have negative conception. So now, actually, point is that four sampradaya, they are authentic sampradaya. But anyway, I was bound to prove yesterday that Madhvacharya sampradaya is more, you know, advanced to break Mayavad Siddhanta, to give bhakti. At the same time, how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to accept Madhva Sampradaya. First point, he accepted Madhvacharya in Guru form and Vyasadev form, in the form of Vyasadev Goswami. And here also Prabhu. And another vital point is that in Madhvacharya Sampradaya, they 100% believe in Krishna Lila, though Madhvacharya wanted to fix up one target, but internally we can know from his writing, he is very much interested about Madhur Bhajan. I already told you. But maybe it was the instruction of Supreme Lord, so up to that point he approached. You have no right to criticize all Acharyas, those who are coming here by the desire of Supreme Lord. But you can say, why this Acharya speaking this way? Why Ramanuja Jojo going to speak this way? Why Madhvacharya speaking this way? You can speak. But actually point is that you should take this Siddhanta this way. They actually, before sending those respective Acharya, Supreme Lord giving some instruction. You can remember what kind of instruction was there on Shankaracharya, you know, from Padmapuran. It was the instruction on Shankaracharya. Hey Acharya, you will have to go to this material world and establish Mayavad Siddhanta. I just say, oh my God, you are giving me this seva. What to do? Who can do this seva? You will have to go. So Shankar Bhagavan was given instruction by Supreme Lord, you will have to go in the form of Shankaraha, Shakshat Shankaraha. Shankar came here to establish Mayavad Siddhanta, illusion, Mayavad, Vivartavad. Why? But inside Shankar is full of bhakti. Vaishnavanam yatha sambo, you know, from Bhagavatam. Nimnaganam yatha ganga devanam achyuto yatha Vaishnavanam yatha sambhu purananam tuidam Bhagavatam. Is already there in Bhagavatam. So Shankaraha, Shaksha Shankaraha, Shankara is Bhakti Acharya. We have no right to blame Shankaracharya. But anyway, we have the right to break Siddhanta by the instruction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Guru Bhar. That's why we are doing. But we have nothing to speak. Blame. The Shankaracharya is giving instruction by Supreme Lord. But be careful, the incarnation of Shankaracharya, I mean, Shankar when came, that situation, surrounding situation was so toxic. And Buddhists, those Buddhists take over all power, our whole society. That's why that time it was very urgent to at least send such a powerful acharya who can at least rectify the situation a little bit. Why? Buddhists, they openly speak that we don't believe Veda. And Shankaracharya came, Shankaracharya wanted to keep Veda in front, but backside doing duplicity. Where is it? By the instruction of Supreme Lord. Shankaracharya externally putting Veda, that we believe Veda. But Mahaprabhu in Chaitanya Charitamrita already told, what Mahaprabhu told? Veda mukhe mayabad bodho ke odhik. What wrote? What is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita? Veda mukhe mayabad bodho ke odhik. It is more dangerous than open Buddhavad is saying we don't believe Veda. But Shankaracharya openly showing that we believe Veda. But actually he is not believing. He is not going to believe Veda. No. So Mahaprabhu saying it is more than Buddhist. But still, at that situation, it was 100% necessary to send such acharya who can at least rectify this situation. Buddhism, break Buddhist, Buddhism, I mean those Buddha teachings, and at least they set Mayavad. That time, one by one, one acharya coming to rectify the situation. Be careful, Madhvacharya came late. Before Madhvacharya, Ramanuja Acharya came. Ramanuja Acharya is actually Ram Anuja. Ram Anuja means the younger brother of Rama. So, follow what I say. And I can explain that Kuresh, the number one disciple of Ramanuja, is Ramangsha. He is Angsha avatar of Rama. Follow? Is there? So many conceptions there. But first of all, I like to speak something about, Ramanuja Acharya ji. Most powerful acharya came in South India. One spectacular thing is that all four important acharyas, they all came in South India. All four important acharyas, they all took birth in South India. Follow, South India. So now Madhvacharya took birth, I already told. Now I am going to speak about Ramanuja Acharya. Ramanuja Acharya near Kanjivaram, Kanjipuram. There is one place, there is Bhutapuram. At present you can say Madras, you see. And yesterday I told, near the place of Trivandam, it is actually, pronunciation is not Trivandam. We speak wrong way. Actually, Sanskrit pronunciation is Trivandam. Trivandam. We speak Trivandam. Wrong way. Trivandam, actually. So, near Madurai, Madras, they are actually one place, Mahabhutapuri. Mahabhutapuri, they are actually this great acharya of bhakti cult. He took birth in the family of a very, very pure Brahman. Yesterday I was supposed to speak so many things about the exclusive Siddhanta of Madhvacharya, but I couldn't make up my time. Someday if I can make up, I can speak more and more about Siddhanta. I couldn't speak. A little bit I could touch. So today I can try something, what to do. Actually, Madhvacharya took birth in pure Brahman family, and Ramanujaja also took birth in pure Brahman family. Very high class Brahman family. And name of father was Keshavacharya and mother Kantimati. Mother Kantimati and father Keshavacharya. They are doing bhajan very nicely actually. They are praying to Supreme Lord. So actually, they are actually doing astuti and penances very nicely, doing bhajan. Supreme Lord was very much satisfied, so wanted to send such a boy who can become a big acharya in Vaishnava, you know, field. So that Ramanuja Acharya took birth, actually, and today is a tithi when Ramanuja Acharya leave his body. Today is the disappearance day of Srila Ramanuja Acharya ji. Actually, from very small boyhood, very small age, Ramanuja Acharya was very full of bhakti. Like you can remember when those teacher wanted to put question in front of Prahlad Maharaj. Hey Prahlad, where from you learn this kind of Krishna bhakti? We never teach you? Prahlad Maharaj, the king become very angry. Hey, I send my boy to you, your school, to teach Vishnu bhakti? Where from he is learning Vishnu bhakti? The acharya become frightened. Chanda Marka, speaking, excuse me, O king, we never give lesson about bhakti. Where from he is getting lesson? We don't know. He is automatically getting this kind of lesson. And after that, sometime the acharya become very angry with Prahlad Maharaj and speaking, hey, speak, where from you are getting this kind of bhakti cult? We never teach you this thing. Then Prahlad Maharaj saying, actually, it is not possible for anybody to give me Krishna bhakti. Only Guru Vaishnava can give. Nate vidu swartha gatim hi vidum Vishnum dura sayajid bahirartha manin. So many things, Prahlad Maharaj saying. Similar way, who giving teaching? Actually, Prahlad Maharaj already getting lesson when he was inside the womb of mother, you can remember, from Naraji Maharaj. So actually, Naraji Maharaj is the guru of Prahlad Maharaj. Naraji Maharaj is the guru of Dhruva Maharaj also. So now here we see, who is the teacher of this Ramanuja Acharya? Are Maharaj, somebody putting question in front of me, Maharaj, that boy took birth, but automatically he is showing bhakti. Where from he is learning bhakti? Asking me. I say, Maharaj, bhakti is not a matter of joke, and atma is immortal, not going to die, maybe body. Maybe this boy took lesson, I mean got bhakti previous life. Follow? If you see, without any acharya in present life, he is getting bhakti. Then you can say, how possible, Maharaj? Whereas we know, without acharya, nobody can get bhakti. Yes. Maybe this boy getting bhakti previous life, because acharya chakshudano dilo jai janme janme prabhu se. Now, Tumadaka was speaking. Chakshudano dilo jai janme janme prabhu se. Guru is eternal. Who can say? So, previous life, maybe, he got Bhakti Acharya, famous Acharya, Sadguru, and somehow he missed. So, this life also he is getting Bhakti. Like Gajendra, I already told you. Gajendra, when he got lesson there from Naraji Maharaj, now, actually, you see, Gajendra, Purva Janmanu Shikshitam, previous life he got this kind of bhakti cult. So in this elephant life, he is now elephant. But somehow he developed this kind of memory. Oh, he can remember. Oh, I was Indodumna Raja. I was doing bhakti. Somehow I missed. So this way, it is written in, there, Gajendra Mokshan Leela, that he can remember everything what he got previous life. So this way, actually Ramanuja Acharya is not a ordinary man, is Ram Anuja Lakshmanji Maharaj. So if you can see, he is showing bhakti from childhood. What wrong in it? He is a special acharya, messenger of Supreme Lord. So this way, Ramanuja Acharya expressing bhakti from child, very small. When he was boy, he watching daily that one devotee, Kanchipurna, daily going to to worship Bharadraj, what? I forget. To worship, every day going. So one day, Ramanujacharya, when first I look at him, he could realize he is a great devotee. So one day, every day watching, one day inviting, oh, Prabhu, if you can kindly take prasadam here in our house, then it's very good. Without the permission of father and mother, without the permission of father and mother, this small boy means who? This Ramanuja Acharya invite Kanchipurna to take prasadam in house. So automatically he is coming and taking prasadam, but after he is serving himself, that small boy serving himself. After serving nicely, after taking prasadam, he arranged one bed to take rest and wanted to massage the leg. Then the Kanchipurna became afraid. You are from pure Brahmin family, topmost. I am actually Shudra. Kanchipurna speaking, actually I am Shudra. How I can take message? No, I cannot take. Then Ramanujacharya crying, how you can speak this way? Actually, a Vaishnava is never Shudra. A Vaishnava is never Shudra. We know Haridas Thakur from Muslim family, but we all respect Haridas Thakur topmost. He is the topmost Acharya in the world, Nam Acharya. Nam Acharya is topmost Acharya. So how we respect? So it matters little, which family, which caste. Is those who are going to think about the Acharya, in which family this Acharya took birth? Which family? What is this? It's not good. It's very bad. So Kanchipurna, full of devotion, bhakti. So Ramanujacharya, from very boyhood, wanted to establish Vaishnava Siddhartha. Ramanujacharya speaking, oh Prabhu, how you are speaking this way? Actually, Vaishnav, this designation is more than Brahman. You are full of bhakti. You know, Satokop, the name of Satokop, he is from low caste. He got big bhakti. And you know, another name I forget. He got big bhakti, Shudra, from low caste. He took birth. All Brahman, all Vaishnava respecting him this way. His name is, what I forget. All the time I speak, sometimes I forget. Actually, his name is actually, anyway, I can remember. So, Ramanujacharya giving argument. How you can speak this way? There's the those who are having Krishna bhakti, Vishnu bhakti, devotion, they are much more than Brahman. So, I am very sorry to hear this kind of Siddhanta from you. Anyway, he was humble enough to speak this way. Not that he not knowing any Siddhanta, but still this speaking this way. So now actually, someday, Ramanujacharya wanted to get lesson. Lesson means education. Is growing up and his exclusive, exclusive brain. Brain means not ordinary brain. He is having so much, power, like Mata Acharya already told. Whatever he is learning, he can memorize in one day. Whatever he is, learning, in one shot, every finish. One time hearing, finish. So this way he become great Vidwan, Pandit, learning all Vyakaran, Sanskrit, everything. After that, he wanted to get lesson about Vedanta, Vedanta. So he wanted to go to Kanjivaram. There, one Acharya, Yadavacharya, he wanted to, because that time he was big you know, common, you know, big, you know, master of Vedanta. Maybe Mayavadi Vedanta, but still that time no Vedanta was there. Anyway, so he wanted to go there, to take lesson there, where? To Jadavacharya, there. So Jadavacharya actually is Mayavadi. Jadavacharya actually, he is from Sankar Sampradaya, always want to establish Mayavad Siddhanta. So Ramanuja Acharya, his name, in childhood, what was the name of Madhvacharya? I told you, Vasudev. And what was the name of Ramanuja Acharya? Lakshman Deshik. Lakshman Deshik was the name in boyhood. So Lakshman Deshik wanted to go to Kanjiburam there to get lesson about Vedanta. But actually, anyhow, there when getting lesson, it is a system through Acharya Seva you will have to get lesson. Because Krishna already told, speaking in Gita, that if you like to get Tata Siddhanta, so Tadvidhi Panipatena Paripashnena Sevaya Upadekshantite Gyanam Gyanina Tattva Darshinaha. Krishna giving this instruction to Arjuna, Tadvidhi, be sure that you will have to collect Tattva Siddhanta, get Tattva Siddhanta with realization. You will have to serve the Acharya. Without serving Acharya, you cannot get lesson properly. So, Tadvidhi Panipatena Paribhashana Sevaya Upadekshantite Gyanam Gyaninas Tattva Darshinaha. Those who are Tattva Darshinaha, Tattva Darshi, they can give you, you know, lesson provided you are serving them. Tadvidhi, mane, know it was your Panipat, mane, pranam, Panipat, mane, prakishta pranam. We are speaking, Dandavad Maharaj. That is not actually exact pranam. Guru Maharaj used to say, they are coming here in front of me, they are paying Dandavad, they are speaking Banchakalpadur, everything. But actually, their pranam is not scientific. Because why? Because they are not giving their mind to me. Follow. If you can give your material mind to me, then I can save your mind, purify and give to you back. And you can do Krishna Bhajan. But anyway, you are going to give this and that, money, this, but not mind. Cake and fruits, everything you can give, but not mind. If you can give mind, then I'm very satisfied. Actually, Panipat means, Guru Maharaj used to say, they are actually not giving from heart, not paying Dandavad. They are speaking Banchakalpadurvastha, paying Dandavad, speaking also, not giving mind. So their pranam, Panipat, is not perfect, not scientific. Follow? Tadvidhi Panipatena Paripashnana. Paripashnana means not to get an interview of your teacher. How far my Gurudev is knowing, let me put one question, let me see, he can give answer or not. This is not good. So this kind of question is not Paripashnana. Paripashnana means prakishta prashna, without any false ego, from heart you want to get solution of your life, so you are putting question, that is called Panipat and Paripashnana. Sevaya means you will have to serve from heart. What kind of seva a brahmachari or sannyasi should do, it is there already in Bhagavatam. But you have no chance to go through that chapter. Nobody likes to interpret, because if they interpret, then some loophole can come out. Follow? So nobody likes to speak this way. Actually, point is that there is already given. How you can, those who are brahmachari, how they should lead their life in the house of Gurudev, in Vidyalaya. It's already there, but nobody likes to speak this way. So, seva is a must. Even Ramachandra, even Bhagavan Sri Krishna, they are also expressing total, complete seva mood. What to speak about you and me? Krishna Bhagavan also? Total seva mood expressing. So, Gurudev, Gurudev blessing Krishna. Gurudev is Supreme Lord. Eh? But still Gurudev blessing. You can get all your teaching, you know, all the time fresh can appear inside your mind, all Vedanta by my blessing. Gurudev blessing to Krishna, Supreme Lord, Krishna. So Krishna enjoying full grip, Guru Kipa. Krishna enjoying full Guru Kipa. Ramachandra enjoying full Guru Kipa. See, Chaitanya Chandra enjoying full Guru Kipa. Whereas I am not enjoying full Guru Kipa. How to speak Harikatha? This way actually, so Tadvidhi Panibas Paribhasana. So Ramanuja took decision to serve Acharya and get lesson. So anyway, he is going to follow the same procedure what is there in scripture. But one day, day to day, sometime it happened, Kanchipuram, there, one king is there, his daughter is going to marry shortly. Daughter, very young daughter actually. But somehow one ghost enter into the body of that daughter. Follow? Then king become mad. How possible? Two or three days only left for marriage. How possible? If everybody knowing my daughter, ghost catching my daughter, then how can break? He was very anxious. Very secretly he sent messenger to Jadavacharya. He is actually knowing mantra, everything. Call him. Jadavacharya quickly. Because there's a big problem. So we should get solution. Jadavacharya crying. Big way. What happens? Actually, my daughter actually ghost. Very secretly, you drive away. Jadavacharya going to give mantra. Swaha! Swaha, this is a mantra. But the ghost become very angry. Hey! I can kill you, idiot. Ghost become very angry with Jadavacharya. Ghost saying, you have no power to drive me. Your student, actually Lakshman Desik, if he can come, if you can get the water wash of the lotus feet of Lakshman Desik, then I can go away. Then the teacher become very afraid. How possible? I am already insulted by this ghost. Oh my God. My character is exposed in front of a public. Huh? He was snake, that ghost speaking. Actually, previous life he was Goshap, you know. At the time of flood, you can type one type of snake. That snake is special snake. You know, like crocodile, you know. Crocodile shape. Takshak also that kind of shape, like crocodile. The takshak can fly and it cannot fly. I have seen in the time of 2000 flood, 88, I have seen. It's in highland. But no, usually they are not going to cut any a bit. Usually no, if they are heavily disturbed, then they can. Then ghost speaking, he was actually Gosap. He was Gosap, snake, previous life. But somehow he have had the opportunity to take the food remains from the plate of Uchista of a Vaishnava. I mean, Uchista plate is there. Everybody throw lip, but the snake somehow go and taking licking that Uchista of a pure Vaishnava. And now this life, he is getting this body. Brahma. So you see, so you have no power to drive me. Your student, you call your student. Student man Lakshman Desik, if you can give the water wash of the lotus feet of Lakshman Desik, then I am going to leave this daughter. Then everybody is surprised, how possible is Acharya big, knowing so much mantra. Anyway, arrangement was done. So, when the king giving the water wash from the lotus feet of Lakshman Desik, that ghost gone, leaving that daughter of the king, then anyway, Acharya feeling, I am insulted today. That boy is heavy. Anyway, from then and there, some envious attitude growing. Follow. Envious attitude growing. And one day, I already told Ramanuja, you are going to serve Acharya. One day, Acharya almost sleeping, and Ramanuja is going to rub oil, massage oil on body. And Acharya going to explain one sloka that the lotus mouth of Supreme Lord is very nice, and the, you know, the eyes is just like a very red color, very red color, very reddish. But how he is comparing? He is saying, his eyes is as much red as the backside of monkey. You have seen the backside of monkey is red. This way he is going to compare with the lotus, you know, eyes of Ramanuja just started crying. So he is messaging, and you know, these tears rolling down his cheeks and hot water just drop on the back of the Acharya. Acharya is saying, how from, where from hot water coming? Look, you crying? Why? Actually, I am crying because you compare the lotus eyes of Supreme Lord with the backside of monkey. So, it is the definition of Acharya Shankar. You know, if you know, you explain? Yes, very angry. But it is the explanation by Acharya Shankar. What I can do? You are going to find fault with him? What kind of explanation you can give? Foolish. He's speaking this way. Then Ramanuja in very appealing mood speaking. You are giving this kind of definition. Kong mean water. Kong mean water. Mane actually Kong Jalam Pi Pibati it is Surya. Surya mean sun god. Follow what I say. Kopi. Kong mean water. Pi Pibati by is called actually sun god. Kopi. Kong Pibati is sun. So how and actually it is Kapisham Asdhatu actually is to express gradually. Kapisham is this kind of word. I forget actually. So actually the meaning of this word is Kong mean water. Actually sun god drinking water by is giving scorchy sunlight after drinking water. Kong pibati, kong mani water, pibati pi mani pan, drinking by sun god. Sun god. So, as dhatu explaining expansion. So, Ramanuja is going to explain this way, this word, that actually by the power of sunlight, when sun rises, then actually lotus flower gradually get expansion. I mean, petals get full blossom form. Follow? So this way Ramanuja is giving nice explanation. So the lotus eyes of Supreme Lord is just like the petals of a lotus flower when get expansion fully by sunlight. Then Jadavacharya become very angry. Hari, he is explaining this way. I am defeated by him, my student. So become very angry. Then he is giving argument. Actually, what you are explaining, this is not actually actual vyakha. Actual explanation is by Shankaracharya, and you are giving secondary explanation. It is not primary. So this way somehow pass away the judgment of disciple, but he could realize one by one, that today or tomorrow this boy going to become a big acharya in Vaishnava Sampradaya. He is going to destroy this Mayavad Sampradaya. I told already actually, Shankaracharya is Kevaladvaitavad. Shankaracharya? Shankaracharya Kevaladvaitavad. Sankarajajo Kevala Duitabad Ramanuja Jajo Bishista Duitabad Madhacharjo Duitabad and actually Nimbarga Jajo Vedavet Bad Vedavan Duitad Duito and Vishnu Swami actually Suddha Duitabad Bhaskaracharjo late on and one Acharya came his Opadhik. Upadhik Bhedavet Bhat, so many darshanic, I mean philosophical view there with despotic Acharya. So we each of them have some speciality. This Acharya has some speciality. This Acharya has some speciality. This Acharya has some, but all Acharya having some deviation from each other. But basic principle they believe. Basic point is all same. Devotion. But they have some disparity. But when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came here in this material, in this world, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu watching all four sampradaya and giving a nice solution, Achinta Vedavet Tattva. Follow us here. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving us one nice Siddhanta Achinta Vedavet Tattva. Through this Achinta Vedavet Tattva, you can get all four sampradaya some disparity. You can get all Siddhanta in a balanced way, very, very balanced way. Scientifically balanced way. Scientifically balanced way, you can get nice Siddhanta, which is called Achinta Vedavet Siddhanta. And our Tattva Acharya, who Jiva Goswami Pad, establishing this Achinta Vedavet Tattva in a very gigantic way, very nicely. So it's above all. Anyway, so now actually, Yadavacharya could realize this boy today or tomorrow going to become a peak Acharya. He's going to destroy all Mayava Siddhanta. So better if he can kill this boy right now. He wanted to took decision, he planned, he may make a nice plotting. Another day when from Upanishad, Sattam Jnanam Anantam, this from Vedanta Sutta, he is going to explain Upanishad. Oh, from Vedanta, not Upanishad. So this Tattva, when Yadavacharya explaining, that time, Lakshman Deshik, in a very humble mood, speaking, Gurudev, you are speaking this way, actually you want to establish impersonal Brahma. But I like to speak this way because this is bhakti. Because Supreme Lord has some eternal feature. You want to speak, there is no eternal feature. So if I speak this way, explain, then Lakshman is speaking nice way. Satyam Jnana Manam. Acharya, you can stand. Oh, he's going to insult me all the time. I cannot, stand in front of him. This boy is only very, small age. Oh my God, better if we can kill him. So make a nice planning, plotting. How? But Lakshman Deshik, I am going to take bath in Allahabad. You like to go? If you like to go, we all can go. Yes, I can go. Then you see, all students, together with this Lakshman Deshik, and in leading part, who? Acharya. Yadavacharya is going, and behind all students going, have a nice planning that when we can enter into Bindharanya forest, Bindhachal forest, you know? Bindhachal Prabhupada, you heard the name? Bindhachal in South India? You heard? No? Oh my God, foolish. So, North India and South India, partition. Bindhachal, so important. Oh my God. At the bank of Bindhachal, Narmada Nadi, there was a big fighting with demigods and Brittacharya. Britta, you know? Demon. Ariba, Britta. Britta, you don't know? Brittasur. He is Acharya because he is bhakti. I say Acharya, the bhakti is there. Bittasur had this big fighting there. Actually, as per the previous plan, they are going to kill That's when they seek somehow. Acharya is just a little bit separate, is going advance, and backside all, you know, student coming, they want to throw Lakshman Desik into deep forest so that tiger and lion can come and you know, jump into Lakshman Desik and eat him up. This is the planning. And snack is also there, deep forest, little hilly place, if you throw him, we cannot climb up. This way, actually, they are planning. But Govinda is a cousin, actually, the son of you know, Matt, sister of mother, cousin, sister of mother, his son, cousin actually. So Govinda very secretly inform you, you fly from here, they have a plan to kill you. Really? Yes, you fly. He is running like mad, Lakshman Desik. But when Jagavacharya is watching that Govinda coming, Govinda, where is Lakshman Desik? I don't know. I thought he is coming advance. No, he is not coming. Maybe backside, I don't know. Then Jadavacharya took decision, maybe he is going to die today. My plan is very success. I can take rest nicely. Nobody can break my Siddhanta. Nice. In the meantime, when Lakshman Desik running through forest running, like mad running. After that, he was very, you know, tired. After that, actually, he confused where to go. Where is forest? He don't know where to go. This whole forest, all direction. Where to go? By chance, he is crying and taking shelter of Supreme Lord. Where to go? How to go? All on a sudden, he discovered one, you know, bad, you know, hunter. Hunter, one hunter with wife going somewhere. He says, excuse me, where you are going? Actually, we are going Bharadraj temple there. Oh, I also like to go. You can take me? Yes, you can take. Go with us. Then after night time, they are going to take rest under a banyan tree. Night time, big banyan tree, taking rest. And the wife of that hunter became so much thirsty, midnight. The Lakshman Desik is saying, I am a young man, I can search water and I can collect water if you... No, don't go, night time it is... But you are very thirsty actually today. I can arrange water if you give permission. Maybe somewhere water is there. No, we cannot allow you to go. That hunter and wife, with a loving mood, say, though I am very thirsty, I cannot allow you to go alone in night time. Well, just in the morning time, just dawn, you know, just sun going to, just before 48 minutes before. Just a red car coming. Then Lakshman Desik going in search of water, and there's no pot. How to bring water? Lakshman Desik is very healthy. His hand is very big hand, taking water this way and coming to that, the wife of that hunter, and going, you drink water, I am giving. This way, three times, his hand is very big. He is very healthy. Lakshman Desik is coming three times water. But the wife of that hunter drinking water three times. Fourth time when going and come back with water, he find that couple is not there. Vanished. Where is gone? It's forest. Then he find it is not forest. It is there so many people, devotees, chanting, shouting. He said, what happens? Where I am? He took in moment, where I am actually? You are in Bharadra temple. Eh? I am in Bharadra temple? How possible? I was in forest, almost thousands of miles away from this. Oh, how possible? Then he consult with Kanchipuram. Kanchipuram said, no, you are very lucky. You are very lucky. That was not hunter. The hunter wife was Lakshmi Narayan. The hunter And wife was just Lakshminarayan, not ordinary hunter wife. So he is shedding tears. I am very lucky this way. This way actually, Lakshman Deshik was saved by the mercy of Lakshminarayan. I forget to speak you that the maternal uncle of Ramanujacharya was Soilopurno. I forget to speak. So when Ramanujacharya took birth, first I go back to speak this point. When Ramanujacharya took birth, then this Soilacharya came in the house of Kantimati. Kantimati, actually Kantimati is elder sister of Soilopurno. Soilopurno is a maternal uncle. Follow my point. Actually, Soilopurno is the father of the mother of Ramanujacharya. Follow my point. Very easy. Ramanujacharya, his mother is Kantimati, his brother, younger brother is Soilopurno. He is also, follow my point. Soilopurno is a disciple of Jamunacharya. Soilopurno is the disciple of Jamunacharya. And Kanchipurno, whom he invited already before, I know, I already told, wanted to mess, he is also a disciple of Jamunacharya. Be careful. They are all disciple of that big Acharya, Jamunacharya. Follow what I say, Jamunacharya. Now actually, Soilopurno give the name, his name should be Lakshman Deshik. Why? When the child took birth, he find all the symptom of Lakshman. Soilacharya watching the boy, he find all the symptoms of Lakshman. Ramanuja Lakshman. So you see, his name must be Lakshman Deshik. Now I come back to the original point. Now from forest, somehow, by the mercy of Lakshminarayan, Lakshman Deshik is saved. He finds himself just there in Dama of Baladacharya. He is very, very happy. Very happy. Follow. So now actually, Ramanujacharya and Lakshman Deshik wanted to take precautionary measure. I must lead my life in a very safe way so that I can preach bhakti cult and break. Maybe Jadavacharya is very envious with me. He like to kill me. Now by the mercy of Supreme Lord, I am saved today. But someday, when they come back again, back, Kanjivoram, they find Lakshman Deshi. They thought Lakshman is also dead, already died. They took decision law in the meantime, maybe Lakshman is missing, maybe Lakshman is already dead. But when they come back in the temple with this, Jadavacharya watching, hey, Lakshman is there, become frightened. He is acting in such a way that he is very happy to see Lakshman. Lakshman, we thought you are missing, you are dead. Very lucky we are. Lakshman is very careful. You can again come and take lesson from me. Lakshman says, yes, I can come. But he inside, he is going to prepare himself in such a way so that this, you know, wicked personality, I mean that dangerous man actually, this Jadavacharya cannot do any harm to me. Now in the meantime, Lakshman Deshik is crying to take Diksha from Kanchipurno. Hey Kanchipurno, hey Acharya, please give me Diksha. He is praying in front of Kanchipurno. Kanchipurno, oh my God, how I can give Diksha? Actually, I am from low caste. I cannot give Diksha to you. But Lakshman Deshik not going to obey anything. I want to get Diksha from you. What to do? Then Kanchipurno took decision to cheat Ramanujacharya in a very tricky way. In the meantime, I forget to speak you, by the order of father and mother, this Lakshman Desik was bound to accept wife, I mean marriage. And the wife is very dangerous. Wife is so dangerous, always he is popped up. I am Brahmin family. My husband is, you know, big Acharya, this. This way all the time. But Ramanujacharya is very humble. Ramanujacharya, I forget to tell you yesterday that Madhvacharya also wanted to prove that though I am from pure topmost Brahmin family, still I want to follow Pancharatik Vidhan. Someday I can explain this point. Follow. Some Siddhanta of Madhvacharya and how Madhvacharya from the very beginning, from childhood, wanted to establish Pancharatik Vidhan. But know it for sure, Pancharatik Vidhan is topmost Vidhan in Kalikal. In all scripture you can find that Pancharatik Vidhan is you know, scientific Vidhan, scientific procedure. All other procedure is not scientific. What is Pancharatik Vidhan? In Pancharatik Vidhan, if you approach a Sadguru mind, what I mean to say, follow my point, very scientific. If you want to approach a Sadguru, Sadguru want to accept you in a Pancharatik Vidhan way. Why? As per Pancharatik Vidhan, those who are already having you know, quality, those who are already having quality and power, they can follow Pancharatik Vidhan, cannot follow. But still, Madhvacharya wanted to prove that Pancharatik Vidhan is most scientific, we like to follow it. Ramanujacharya also. So, what is Pancharatik Vidhan? As per Pancharatik Vidhan, those who are inclined to Sadguru, they are praying to Sadguru, Sadguru, you save me, upo nayati iti upanayan. Upo nayati sisyam, veda samipe, iti upanayan. Upanayan, this word, I mean, upo nayati veda samipe, iti upanayan. Upanayan sanskar. So, it is the duty of powerful Acharya to take, catch the hand of disciple, come with me, my boy. He can take and come in front of Veda. Veda means Supreme Lord. Absolute truth. And Sisha also have to carry Samid. Samid means wooden piece to be sacrificed in fire. But actually this meaning is submission. Follow what I say. So this is a system. But actually point is that by Pancharatik Vidhan, if you have half quality or 80% quality, follow. So this way, Pancharatik Vidhan means first you will have to get the keep of Acharya. Gradually you go on following Acharya's instruction. Today or tomorrow, through Pancharatik Vidhan, you can attain that level. Follow. You can attain that level, topmost level. This is called Pancharatik Vidhan. You have no quality. Maybe he has no quality. But we are in Pancharatik Vidhan. So somehow today or tomorrow, if you are following Gurudev, Sadguru, Vaishnava, today or tomorrow we can come out successful. This is the actual meaning of Pancharatik Vidhan. Pancharatik Vidhan, Sanskar and Reformation. There. So Madhvacharya always wanted to follow this Pancharatik Vidhan. Someday I can speak in front of you. Ramanujacharya is from high Brahmin family. Still, Ramanujacharya wanted to follow Pancharatik Vidhan, which is approved by all authentic scripture. This way, so in the meantime, actually, when Ramanujacharya was bound to marry, what to do? That the wife is very dangerous. Ramanujacharya somehow managing. So when Kanchipurno see that wife is very dangerous, actually, he never believed Guru Vaishnava. Say Kanchipurno wanted to take shelter of wife so that Ramanujacharya not going to take shelter from me. I am from low family. It is not one kind of, you know, conspiracy. It's out of his humble mood. I am very low family. If I go to Dikha to Ramanujacharya, it's not good. So better I take I speak this matter to wife, wife can speak with husband, and they can drop this matter. Follow what I say. It's well out of humbleness. It's not conspiracy. It's not conspiracy. Out of humble mood. How I can give diksha to, you know, Lakshman Deshik? Then Ramanuja, actually Lakshman Deshik crying in front of Kanchipurna. Then you are not going to give me diksha. Whom to, where to take diksha? Then Kanchipuram speaking, I can take permission from Bharadraj, Supreme Lord, and speak you after. Then after that, one day, he received order from Bharadraj, his Gurudev is Mahapurna. Then Kanchipurna coming and speaking in front of Lakshman Desik, Lakshman, actually your Guru is Mahapurna. Mahapurna? Yes. Mahapurna is your Guru. I got instruction from Supreme Lord. Really? So today I like to meet Mahapurna. I like to go. He is running and running and running to meet Mahapurna. In the midway, somehow he meet Mahapurna. Mahapurna also, the disciple of Bharadacharya. Be careful. Mahapurna is a disciple of Jamunacharya. Be careful. All I speak. Who? Sailapurna, Kanchipurna, eh? All they are the disciple of Yamunacharya, big Acharya. This way, he took Pancharatik Diksha, everything, Sanskar, everything. After that, one day in the temple of Bharadraj, Jamunacharya was very much interested to see Lakshman Deshik. In the meantime, the name and fame of Lakshman Deshik spreading everywhere, like the fragments of flower, sweet smell. So Jamunacharya, the great Acharya, already knowing the name of, oh, I like to meet Lakshman Deshik. Maybe he can become a big Acharya near future. So I like to meet him. So when Jamunacharya came in the temple of Bharadacharya, there by chance, by the mercy of Supreme Lord, he watched Lakshman Deshik there. They're so much attracted, very nice, full of bhakti. But he couldn't approach him directly. He took one decision. He requesting Mahapurna, Stotra Ratna written by me, I am going away. It is your duty to recite this Stotra Ratna in front of Supreme Lord. By chance, Ramanucharya, I mean Lakshman Deshik, is coming. He had the chance to hear this Stotra Ratna. Surely he is going to be attracted. It's a plan. Jamunacharya speaking this, giving instruction, and gone away. Gone. In the meantime, it is the arrangement of Bharadacharya, Supreme Lord, is going to recite this, you know, Stotra Ratnavali, very sweet, you know, tone. And by chance, you know, Lakshman Deshik came entering the temple. He said, so nice, sweet, you know, voice coming where? Oh, he's right. Very stern and still. He was stunned to hear this kind of sweet mellow. Oh. After the Stotra is over, he approaching. Please speak me. It is written by whom? Written by whom? Hey, Jamunacharya. I like to meet Jamunacharya today. I like to meet. Well, you come with me. Then he taking, taking whom? Lakshman Deshik. Come, let us go in front of Jamunacharya. They are going very sweet mood. In the meantime, midway, took information, the Acharya already gone away from this. How? They break down in midway. Break down in tears, blasted into tears. Oh, I am unlucky so. Jamunacharya gone? Yes. Jamunacharya gone. Then Mahapurna and Lakshman Deshik, both crying and crying. They running and running to meet who? Jamunacharya. Because it was the instruction of Jamunacharya, after my death, no Mayavadi, no smart Brahman can touch me, my body. It was the standing instruction of Jamunacharya that after my death, be careful, no Mayavadi, no smart Brahman can touch me. Only pure devotee can touch me. They are running and running heavily. They go, they say the transcendental body of Jamunacharya lying, but three hand folded, three finger, this way. Why? Everybody is thin, but three finger is folded. Then Ramanujacharya paid dandavat and, you know, heavily thinking. Out of his, you know, extraordinary, I mean transcendental, you know, power, he could realize it must be so that three important desire of this Acharya not fulfilled today. Still today not fulfilled. Follow what I say. Three main desires of this Acharya still today not fulfilled. Then Jamunacharya thinking. Then he approached all those old devotees. Old devotees. They asking, why three hands? But three desires of this Acharya is not fulfilled as yet. So you have any information about this? Well, actually, not complete information, but I know, actually, Acharya wanted to guide all this common society in a very Vedic way, very scientific way, through Pancharatrik Vidhan. Well, I touching this body, transcendental body, I speak, I have commitment, I speak, I promise that I am going to fulfill this desire. Then one finger, three fingers was closed, one finger open. Another two, it was the desire of Acharya to compile a very nice, you know, commentary of Vedanta. Ramacharya give again resolution. I promise, I am going to publish one nice commentary of Vedanta as per the desire of this Jamunacharya, great Muni, Jamun Muni. Then another finger open, three finger open. Parasar Muni writing nice, you know, history. I mean, it's one kind of Puran, in which he wanted to establish the glories of Supreme Lord, what is the relation of Jivatma with Supreme Lord, this way. So nobody can understand, it's so complicated. So Jamunacharya wanted to give some indication through one index, you know, dictionary. So Jamunacharya gave another commitment. I promise, I want to follow this Puran written by, you know, Parashar Muni. I can compile one dictionary. I mean, Vaishnava is our Vaishnava Vidhan, you know, our Gauriya Vaishnava Vidhan. You heard? Gauriya Vaishnava Vidhan. I am going to publish one dictionary. Then three finger open. Then Jamunacharya satisfied. Then Ramanacharya on and on, now took diksha, actually hook over. Then Ramanacharya took decision to take sannyas. But there is no way. Wife is there inside room. Very dangerous wife. What to do? One day, very nice, after taking diksha from Mahapurno, actually, he requests Gurudev, if you are going to stay here, I like to serve you. It's very good. I am here staying. You can stay there. Gurudev, okay. If you like to stay with me, okay. But by the mercy of Supreme Lord, one day, what happens? His wife is very dangerous. Popped up. One day, the wife of Mahapurno, I mean, wife of Gurudev, going to take water from, you know, well, coop. With, you know, rope, you know, we catch water, we pull. And in the meantime, the wife of Ramanujacharya also going to take water at the same time. So he is pulling the rope, water from deep, pulling wire, wheel, you know, they are getting water up. So in the meantime, water from the pot of that, Acharya, and wife of Gurudev coming in drop in the pot of Ramanujacharya's wife. He is putting what? He become very angry. He is speaking all rubbish. You are from a low caste. Your water coming in my pot. This way fighting heavily. The wife of Acharya become frightened, going to home, speaking in front of husband. And Gurudev's Mahapurna took decision, this kind of incident I cannot allow anymore. So it is good, better. Today and now I am going to leave this place and going to Kanchipura. Finish problem. I am not going to fight anymore. This kind of incident can happen tomorrow also. I am from low family. My disciple Shailapurna, Lakshman Desikan, high family, his wife speaking this way. When Ramanujacharya came back, Lakshman Desikan, he said, where Gurudev gone? Wife not speaking anything. He took information from neighbors. Neighbors mean those who were residing. Oh my God, he's so dangerous wife. And he is an envious attitude with Guru Vaishnav. So it is the rule. It is the usual rule. Those who are against Guru Vaishnav, you should not go there to take prasadam. Here Harikatha, you cannot go. Those who are against Vaishnav, those who are Vaishnav aparadhi, Vishnu aparadhi, Vaishnav aparadhi, Guru aparadhi, you should not look his face also. Vaishnav ninduker mukho naheribo. You cannot see the face of that man who is insulting Guru Vaishnava all the time. Be careful. It is the rule. So Ramanujaja took decision, oh Bharat Raj, bless me, how I can get an opportunity to throw my wife away. Not getting in. One day, one beggar, Brahman coming. I am very hungry. Can you give some prasadam? Is coming in the house of your attention please. Is coming in the house of Lakshman Deshi. Follow. In the house of Lakshman Deshi, I am begging for some bhiksha. Brahman, I am very hungry. Can you give some? Wife is like, you know, witch you know? Oh, go away. Prasadam. No time I have. Go. You drive him away. And nearby Lakshman Deshik was doing bhajan. That Brahmin crying and coming in front of, what happens, Brahmin? Actually, I go in your house, I beg prasadam. He chide me in heavily and, you know, drive me away. Well, happy. Hear me. Don't cry. I have one plan. What plan? Actually, I can give you one card in which it is written, your brother going to marry, so in marriage ceremony, this marriage ceremony going to be happened on that day, so I am coming from the house of your father, so please come with me. You speak this way. I am here. What result you see? Then the Brahmin again coming, going with the card giving by Ramanuja. Actually, I am coming from your father's house. Father's house? Yes. Actually, marriage ceremony of your brother. Really? Yes. Where is card? Ah, I like to go. That's why I come, to take you. In the meantime, Lakshman Acharya coming. Lakshman, what happens? Actually, this Brahman coming, we invited. Lakshman already knowing. Actually, this Brahman coming, he invited some letter to take me. Well, I also approve. You cannot go. I can also go. First you go, because his brothers, and it is my proposal. You can take all your nice ornament, what all you have. All your ornaments and all nice clothes, everything, topmost, you can take everything. Because who can say, long ceremony is a long time, you get, we have to change clothes. Yes, you are right, I can take everything. He take all ornaments and clothes, everything, and gone with that Brahman, and Ramanujaja took bath in Ananta Sarovar. Oh, Supreme Lord, I am now free. And going to take bath in Ananta Sarovar, and took sannyas in front of the photo of Jamunacharya. Oh Prabhu, from today, I am 100% sold unto your lotus feet. I have no connection with wife. Cut. And took sannyas. Jamunacharya. photo of Jamunacharya, took bath in Ananta Sarovar and came in front of Jamunacharya photo and took Tidandi Sannyas. Tidandi Sannyas. Now go on preaching heavily, very nice preaching going on. Breaking Mayava Siddhanta, this, that. One day, he is requesting Mahapurno Gurudev. He is begging for apology because wife going all, you know, rubbish. Hey Gurudev, my wife is actually, idiot actually. Please excuse me, I leave my wife. It's my one kind of expiation. Please excuse me. I know you actually. Your wife is different type. So I never mind. But actually, point is that you will have to speak all the mystery of this mantra. It is the usual rule, but nobody following. At the time of Diksha, it is the duty of Gurudev to speak all the secrecy of mantra. Sarahasya mantra you will have to speak. And you will have to speak all your feelings, what you feel after doing this mantra. So you are going to give Diksha. So actually, he is requesting in front of Gurudev, I want to know all the secrecy of this mantra. Gurudev spoke, well, I am very happy. But you will have to, one special kripa received by my god brother. His name is Goshtapurno. Follow what I say. Gurudev speaking. Mahapurno speaking, Gurudev speaking in front of Lakshman. Lakshman, actually what to speak? I have my elder god brother. His name is Goshtapurno. If you can go to Goshtapurno, he is knowing all mystery of mantra, really. I can speak, but if you go directly to him, it's more good. Because my Gurudev Jamunacharya, very secretly giving him teachings. About this. Oh, really? Yes. So, I'm taking address and going to where? To meet this Goshtapurno. Goshtapurno, who is knowing, he is Gyastha. He is also Gyastha, this Gurudev. I already told, Mahapurno is also Gyastha. So, what? He approached whom? Goshtapurno. And pay prostrate at Dandavat. He must give. You know, I like to know all the secrecies of mantra. Because though I know I am going to receive this mantra in same, you know, disciplic order, but I like to know the scientific definition, secrecy. But Goshtapurno going to cheat Ramanujaja 18 times. Goshtapurno going to cheat Ramanujaja 18 times. No, today I have no time, you come. No, actually, I can ask Supreme Lord. It's not so easy. This way, 18 times, Ramanujaja was refused. Still, Ramanujaja going and going. Please, don't, you know, cheat me, you keep me. Then after testing, Goshtapurno could realize he is not ordinary personality. It's nice. So I should give. Well, I can give you. But one condition. What condition? You cannot speak this mantra rahasa in front of anybody. Okay? Yes. And come. Very secretly, all speaking about mantra rahasa, secrecy of mantra, everything. Huh? After getting mantra, after power, Ramanujaja going back to Kanchipuram and in front of 78 people in a room, loudly giving this mantra. And Gurudev became very angry. It was condition. You are going to hell. I told you not to speak this mantra. Ramanujaja in very humble mood. Gurudev, actually point is that I am very selfish. Actually, I have no sacrifice. Now you think it, that if I am going to hell, and if I am going to hell, it is okay. But if I can save this vast population by this mantra, I am very much interested. I go to hell, I never mind. But if I can save all those common people by this mantra, it is my mood. Then Goshtapurno could realize his heart is very high. Well, I bless you. Not only bless, Goshtapurna could realize he is not ordinary man. His heart is very high. By this mantra, he wanted to save all common people. You do bhajan, nicely. But after that, Goshtapurna was so satisfied that Goshtapurna now make him Acharya. Ramanujaji is already Acharya. Because his all his activities, you know, Japari Jamunacharya, three fingers fold open, everybody could understand the high, you know, power of Ramanujaji, Ramanujaji, Lakshman Desi. Now, not only Goshtapurna is satisfied, Goshtapurna now going to give his own son as a disciple of Ramanujaji. Ramanujaji, you give him Diksha. Goshtapurna going to give his own son into the lotus feet of Ramanujaji. You take it. You are powerful. Then and there, actually, his cousin are you told? Govinda, who saved him in the forest. He also, they all took sannyas. They all took sannyas. Ramanujaji gives sannyas. Four or five at a time. And this Kures came late. Another name I forget. Govinda or something. He is Bharatamsa. This way, Kures came second or third. I forget. The Kures became, Kures came late. But Kures became the topmost disciple of Ramanujaya. How we can pass judgment? Who is the topmost? Who is the topmost disciple of Acharya? How we can realize? Many times you speak Siddhanta. Prabhupada told, actually, if you can find that total Siddhanta, total purity, total Vichar, and all activities, Siddhanta of Gurudev, totally reflected, coming into the heart of Shishya, then be sure he is the topmost disciple of that Gurudev. Follow what I say? So Kures was proved to be the topmost disciple of Ramanujaya. Ramanujaya, now remember, I already give commitment in front of Jamunacharya's transcendental body. Now it is the time to fulfill. One by one, Ramanujaya started activities. First, through Pancharatik Dikha, whole mass, he wanted to guide them in a proper way. First, second, he is taking preparation to write Srivasya. Srivasya, you know, Vedanta Vasya by Ramanujaya, his name is Srivasya. Then before writing Srivasya, Ramanujaya took decision, first of all, I must follow the commentary written by Bodhayan. Bodhayan Acharya, previously, he writing a commentary on that, so I like to follow it first. Where it is? Actually, no, it is missing. It is missing. Those Mayavadi, they like to throw it away. Because if Bodhayan Dasa somehow exposed, then nobody going to follow Mayavadi. By the mercy of Bharat Raj, he could realize he is going to Sarada Pit in Himalaya, near Badinarayan Assam, down. There actually Sarada Pit, he are taking rest, and they actually Ramanujaji and Kures both. They're requesting in front of those Mayavadis, actually, we like to go through the Bodhayan Vasya. I already heard it is there with you. No, no, it's not there with us. False. Actually, it is there. But they're already speaking lie. Ramanujaji crying. Ramanujaji crying in front of Supreme Lord, Ho Prabhu, what to do? How to do? Then in the night time, 2 o'clock, almost midnight, Nishingadev appear and giving this Bodhayan Vasya, handing over to Ramanujaji. You take it, I give it to you. You look and write Srivasya. Go away from here. Nishingadev giving instruction. Go away from here. They can kill you. Nishingadev give. Oh, it is lock and key. Who can protect Nishingadev? So hand over. Then Lakshman, I mean Ramanujacharya and Kures running and running and running very quickly so that they can go out of their area. But in the daytime, somehow they got information that Bodhayan Vasya is missing. Oh, it must be Ramanujacharya taking away. They sent 10 very powerful men, go and fight them, kill them, and snatch this Bodhayan Vasya from them. Otherwise, big problem. Then 10 powerful hooligan, gunda, going running here and there, searching where they can go. Oh, searching hilly place. Then they catch them, arrest them. Hey, stop! Give Bodhayan Vasya. They big fighting. Ramanujacharya, what to do? Ramanujacharya not going to fight. He is very powerful. Lakshman was still not going to fight. They snatch that Bodhayan Vasya and go. Within this 1 month, almost it took 1 month to trace out where Ramanujacharya and Lakshman, Ramanujacharya gone. The 10 gunda hooligans searching 1 month time, hilly place, to search about the whereabout of that Ramanujacharya. Where? Arrest them. In the meantime, 1 month was over. When this Bodhayan Vasya was snatched from the hand of Ramanujacharya and Kures, then Ramanujacharya started crying. Oh, Supreme Lord, you bless me, you give blessing, you already give everything, but I am losing everything. What to do? I am undone. Then Kures crying in front of Gurudev, Gurudev, don't cry. Actually, within this 1 month, I recite all Vedanta, Bodhayan Vasya, I can recollect everything, every word. Eh? Really? Yes. I memorize everything within this 1 month. Really? Yes. Within 3-4 days, I can write you intact. Then Ramanujacharya was very happy. Gurudev is sleeping, he is reading. Ah, memorize everything. Within his 1 month, he recite all Bodhayan Vasya. Intact. Intact, what was there? Oh, written by Kures. Kures, right? Ramanujacharya bless him. Kures, you have done a nice job. Now, actually, Ramanujacharya started writing commentary of Srivasya. Started writing of Srivasya. Srivasya was completed. Who is going to stop? Who is going to stop whom? Yesterday I told you. Eh? Who is going to save you? Who is going to save whom? If Supreme Lord is a protector, Supreme Protector, then by chance what happens? Bodhayan Vasya was completed. On the basis of Bodhayan Vasya, original Vasya, he writes Sri Vasya very nicely. Very nice. Then Ramanujacharya one by one. Not only that, actually Yamunacharya was the number one enemy. Jadavacharya, not Yamunacharya. Yamunacharya is the big Acharya. Jadavacharya was the topmost, number one enemy. But the mother of Jadavacharya is Bhakti Mati. Having bhakti. He is fighting with son. I am going to take diksha from Ramanujacharya. What you can do, you can do. Huh? Then the mother of Jadavacharya took diksha from Ramanujacharya. In the meantime, by the request of mother, actually Ramanujacharya also got the scope to change the mind of Jadavacharya. Jadavacharya also took diksha, Mayavadi leave, and took diksha from Ramanujacharya. Not only diksha, took sannyas also. And Govindo, I already told cousin, he was almost Mayavadi, but he was almost Mayavadi because he was staying with Mayavadi. Somehow he changed his mood, follow. Govindo is very nice man, but he was with Mayavadi for a long time, so he changed his mood. So, now Lakshman Desik, Ramanujacharya, engaged Sripurno. Sripurno his maternal uncle, to change his mood. Then also, Govinda coming in front of Ramanujacharya, and Govinda also took Diksha from Ramanujacharya. Also sannyas. This way, Ramanujacharya, massive preaching going on. Massive preaching. Big preaching. Preaching and preaching going on. Almost all Mayavadi, they are going to cut. Mayavadi people, they are very afraid. Sometimes they are fighting with somebody. Sometimes they are going to do some sabotage, you know, giving, you know, fire to destroy your books and this, that. They are doing sabotage work. What to do? They cannot come in front of Ramanujacharya, so powerful Acharya. This way Ramanujacharya come out successful, and he is preaching, you know, what? Ramanujacharya, Vishishtadvaitavad. Now, what do you mean by Vishishtadvaitavad? Kevaladvaitavad mean? Kevaladvaitavad mean? Who? Sankaracharya Kevaladvaitavad. Kevaladvaitavad mean? There is one and single Brahma, Brahma Satya Jagat Mitra. But, Vishishtadvaitavad means, actually, what is the basic structure I like to discuss, actually? First of all, I like to say that their bhajan mood, they like to obey Lakshmi Narayan. Follow my point. They cannot go above Lakshmi Narayan. It is written, they cannot understand the mood of Radha Krishna. Now you can say Ramanujacharya is a foolish acharya. No! It is the arrangement of Supreme Lord. By the order of Supreme Lord, they can approach up to this point. Follow what I say? By the instruction of Supreme Lord, Shankaracharya going up to this point. By the instruction of Ramanujacharya, by the instruction of Supreme Lord, Ramanujacharya going up to that point. Madhvacharya going up to that point. Not that they are not knowing anything. Only we are fighting like idiots with each other. No meaning. Ramanujacharya fix up this target that Lakshmi Narayan is topmost. So with Pancharatrik Vidhan, you will have to worship everything. You can serve Supreme Lord and you can come out successful bhakti. You can get this way. Ramanujacharya going to set this principle, some principle. His instruction is very important, famous. Someday I can discuss. So many instructions given by Ramanujacharya. So many. Ramanujacharya giving instruction, without the shelter of a pure devotee, you cannot save your life. Ramanujacharya giving instruction. Ramanujacharya giving instruction, it is good to leave body. It is better to leave body than to stay with material people. Huh? You know? What Rupa Goswami was writing? Baram huta bho panjarantara vyavasthiti. It is good if all around fire is there. I am captive. Captive means I am inside that prison. And all around fire is also good. But still I cannot mix with material people. Those who are materially moved, those who are materially interested, money, position, rank, kamini, kanchan, in the name of bhajan and prachar, they are collecting. But Ramanujacharya, Ramanujacharya giving instruction, don't go for the association, don't go. Ramanujacharya giving association, if some materially contaminated people, those who are materially contaminated, if you touch them, you will have to take bath with your clothes. Yes, Ramanujacharya told. And Mahaprabhu told, if you see any Mayavadi, you will have to take bath with clothes, everything. So in Haridwar, when I am speaking Harikatha, every time watching Mayavadi, so I can go and take bath? What is the Siddhanta? Yes, I am taking. I am in Vyasasana. Every time I take bath. Whenever I go by Gadi, if I see somebody, I look at sun god, I think the lotus feet of Gurudev, I think Vrindavan, Jagannath, Patit Pavan, I take bath. Because it is written. If you can think Jagannath is the topmost bar. Pavitra va apavitra va sarva avastha gato piva. You forget? So, if you can think the lotus feet of Jagannath is the topmost bath. As such, there is so many bath. You can take bath in sunlight, you can take bath in rain, you can take bath in pond, you can take bath in river, you can take bath in so many dust. In Vrindavan, we are sometime we are impure, take dust, snan, over. This way we are doing. So actually, Ramanuja Acharya told, if some material people is there, in the guise of sannyasi, in the base of tilak, mala, everything, Vaishnava, apron, Ramanuja Acharya speaking. If one material people is in the guise of, you know, Vaishnava, still you cannot go there, you cannot look at them. Very strict. I can speak so much thing. If some deity is established, installed by non-devotee, you cannot pay dandavat. Ramanuja is speaking, if any Shivalinga or any deity is established by pure Brahman or Vaishnava, then it is authentic. Follow. Otherwise, not authentic. Ramanuja is speaking so many things. You must pay due respect to Mahaprasadam. If it is not at all Mahaprasadam, I mean in the society, there's a crazy man, they're engaging some dirty people to cook, and the dirty pujari going to offer, who can put guarantee that Jagannath going to accept? So this way, prasada seva hoite, prasada seva karite hai, sakal prapancha jai. It is written, if I take a pinch of Mahaprasadam, I can conquer this world, cut maya. Whereas so much prasadam, I am taking no cut, still maya bondage. So nobody going to give this scientific definition. Our previous Acharya, I mean our Acharya Prabhupad, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, my Guru Maharaj, Sridhar Goswami used to speak, hey, don't send everybody and each and everybody inside the temple, deity temple, don't send. In cooking room and in deity room, don't send. But they are not going to obey. It is the standing instruction of Sridhar Maharaj. Those who are elevated, pure, you can allow them inside kitchen. I am shouting like dog. That try to protect three places at least. Besasan, where Harikatha is main source of power. Kitchen room. And where? Harikatha Kirtan, this place. Kitchen room and pujari. Three places you have to protect. Because if you have failure to protect, then all danger can come for you all. Danger can come in your life. How? Because one contamination can change your life. Sapa pujari is idiot. He's doing all nonsense inside pujari room. Then all offense going to touch all devotees there staying in temple. Guruma used to say, I know how they are doing arsip. I know them. Still, I am doing archan. I am doing archan every day. So I could realize from then I am very alert. One day Guruma said, I am doing archan. That's why you are saved. He is sitting in room, in bed. He is saying, they are doing archan? I am doing archan every day. All temple. I was from them I alert. So I learned. Acharya is so powerful. If there is any mistake done by any disciple, that can be make up by big Acharya. If Acharya is weak, who can? So any offense done in a kitchen room, in deity room, in Vyasasan, that offense going to touch you also, because you are going to stay this temple. This is the benefit of Goshti Bhajan. If one powerful Acharya Maharaj is there, you are all Vaishnava there, so Goshti Bhajan you can get power. And at the same time, if there is offense, you all will have to take share of that offense. Be careful. So, when we are staying in society, I'm very careful all the time. Prabhupada, I can discuss this point maybe tomorrow or day after tomorrow. No, today, no time. Milyamishya. Milyamishya means very compromised way. Adjusted way we will have to stay. Very adjusted way. All proper adjustment you will have to make to stay in a temple. And you have to, all proper adjustment. Eh? Milyamishya in Bengali. This life is very short. You will have to stay very balanced way, milyamishya in this. So, aki vishay vigraha, aki ashray vigraha. Ashray vigraha Gurudev, powerful Vaishnava. Aki ashray vigraha anugatte, vishay vigraha seva kuriven. Ei dudine jiva manli only a life is very short, so you will have to take decision to serve in a very balanced way, so that you can get. What does you mean? That's mean those who are senior devotee, they can give kripa to junior devotee. Not that junior devotee doing all nonsense, senior devotee can come down to their level and approve that kind of idiotic. Not that. They misexplain. Maharaj, no patience. Maharaj can idiot, foolish. Who told you? Huh? Who told? You will have to adjust with Maharaj. Learn. Not that Maharaj can leave his own position and calm down and do all nonsense with you. Foolish. Maharaj cannot adjust. Foolish people. They are wrong interpretation they are speaking. So, Ramanujaya is speaking so many things. Now, Vishishta Dvaitavada, I like to skeleton discussion, very small way. As far as Vishishta Dvaitavada, Ramanujaya is speaking, this Brahma, actually, impersonal Brahma, you are thinking, but actually this, infinity world is the body of that Brahma. Ramanujaya is speaking, this is, surrounding situation, all Ramanujaya confess chit, achit, chit means the jivatma, the chit, achit means matter and Supreme Lord. Three basic things. I can explain big way, but not now, no time. So chit, achit and Supreme Lord. And buho, Acharya, Archa, all five, giving by five kind of manifestation of Supreme Lord. Five kind of manifestation. I can discuss someday. Now, what is the basic, principle of Ramanujacharya? Ramanujacharya speaking, actually, Chit, Achit and Supreme Lord. And Brahma. So, this material world is a specific, symptom of that Brahma. Follow what I say. Specific symptom of this Brahma. Otherwise, how we can understand? Ramanujaya want to speak, this whole universe is the body of that Brahma. Jivas are always different from Brahma. But at the same time, this world is the full universe, is the body of Brahma. It is in a specific way expressing Brahma. That's why it is called Vishishta Dvaitavada. This material world going to specifically speak what Brahma is. Follow? That is why this Tattva Siddhanta name is Vishishta Dvaitavada. Ramanuja speaking, whole infinity Brahmand is Brahma. But be sure, we know sometime if some people staying there in any kingdom, he will have to follow the order of king. Otherwise, he would be punished heavily. Otherwise, he would be punished heavily if he is going to break the instruction of king. But not the case with Brahma. That in that at the time of annihilation, destruction, Ramanuja is speaking, at the time of full destruction, all creation staying inside Brahma as if one bird flying into forest, you cannot see that bird, where that bird is. Bird is vanished inside the forest. Ramanuja is speaking, the bird is there. You cannot see. It is in a very, you know, hidden. So all this creation in fine form, hidden form, staying inside Brahma and sometime expressing. Brahma expressing himself. But for that, Brahma not going to suffer anything. Brahma is always pure. Brahma is always pure, stainless. Brahma is always pure, stainless, not going to suffer anything, nothing. He, with his own power, in own helm, he is staying very, with full glory. Follow? What is it? This way, Ramanujacharya, Visishtatta Advaitabhad, speaking this way. So, though, and Ramanujacharya is speaking, those Jivatma, there are three kinds of Jivatma. One is bonded soul. Follow? Remember, don't forget. One is, you know, one is this, so you see, bonded soul, another is free from the clutcher of Maya. One is bonded, another is Mukta. Baddha, Bengali, you understand Sanskrit? Baddha, Mukta, one is Parshad, like Guru Radhi. There, three kind of. You know, and also Paro, Bruho, Archa. And another three I forget. Poro Bhu. Another Bigraha. Bigraha. Poro Bhuho Orcha. Orcha mean Bigraha, but foolish. Another two I speak by forget. I can speak, no problem, never mind. And five form actually. Vaibhav. Poro Bhuho Orcha Vaibhav. And another I forget. I can also remember, no problem. This way, Krishna can express, Prabhu, Supreme Lord Brahma can express himself. Ramanuja is speaking that deity is not stone or wooden piece. Is fully alive. Only the difference is that this Vigraha is going to give total anugraha. Vigraha going to give total anugraha on me and going to stand still to allow me to do seva, and someday this happened in Vrindavan. One big Acharya, his name I forget, very nice Acharya. I speak his name. Krishna Gopal Sinaji speaking with him this way. Gopal sitting in front of that Acharya and speaking. I forget, very important Acharya, I forget. With Ballavacharya also, Sinaji used to speak and embrace that deity. Yes. And here our Kalna, you can go. There also, you know, Gauridas Pandit, Ambika Kalna. So don't misunderstand. They are actually that Acharya talking with Supreme Lord, Gopalji, this way. In the meantime, arati time coming, 6:30, and that Acharya running to do arati. Gopal say, hey, come, I'm here. Where you are going to do arati? What speciality there? I'm here. I am here sitting with you. You are running. He is speaking. You see, you are here, but that deity is more merciful than you. You can chide me, you can cheat me. That deity cannot cheat me. So I am going to do arati. First arati, then I can come back. You can wait or you can go, whatever you like. This is a relation with Supreme Lord, you see. So sweet relation. So this way, actually Ramanujacharya, writing so many books, Vashab, Upanishad, Vedanta, Gita, you know, so many writings, see, what to speak about Ramanujacharya, big Acharya, we today like to get kripa from Ramanujacharya, to get full kripa from him so that we can lead our bhajan life very freshly. Papanno Jivanamritovan book is on the basis of Ramanujacharya, published by Srila Swami Maharaj. Very important. Very important. Anyway, today, yesterday, you know, I told you about Madhvacharya Siddhanta, almost same with Gaudiya Siddhanta. Amnaya praha tatyam harimiya sarva saktim rasadhyam tad binnangshangsha jivana prakritikavalitano tad bimuktangsha bhavat bheda bheda sakalamopi harihe suddha bhakti harihe suddha bhaktim Shaddha Titi Tat Pritimeva Iti Upadishati Gaura Chando Swayam Sa Vancha Kalpadarva Sekepas in the Vyasha Patitanang Pavanam Pabit.
Actually, I forget the name of the devotee. His name is Tiruppan Allar. Tiruppan Allar, who took birth in Chandal family. Still, he was respected by all Brahman and Vaishnav. This reference was given by Srila Ramanujacharya, I mean Lakshman Deshi, to, you know, Kanchipurna, you know. And also I forget this thing, actually, the Supreme Lord can express Himself in five different ways, Isha Tattva, I mean Paratattva, Buha Tattva, Vibhav Tattva, Antaryami and Archa. Archaman, which are worshipping, deity. So, Paratattva, Buhatattva, Vibhav, Babaivhavtattva, Antaryami, and Archavatar, this kind of five different way, Paratattva can express himself in this material world. And also, I was supposed to speak clearly about the reference Yadavacharya wanted to give in front of Lakshman Desi, that was totally wrong. It was the commentary by Shankaracharya, with Yadavacharya speaking in front of Lakshman Desi while messaging. So actually he wanted to speak Tasho yatha kapyasam pundari kameva akshini. Tasho yatha kapyasam pundari kameva akshini. Yadavacharya wanted to speak, give this reference, that how the lotus eyes of Supreme Lord, Pundarikaksha, is speaking that it is just like the backside of monkey, which is reddish in color. He compared this way, the beauty of the lotus eyes of Supreme Lord. Then Lakshman Deshik was very, very unhappy, very, very sorry. He was crying. Then Yadavacharya told, why you are crying? He told, I am crying because you are giving dirty example. So then Yadavacharya put challenge. How different way you can explain? Let me hear. Then Lakshman Deshi told, Kang jalam pibati iti kapihi surya. Kwang jalam pivati iti kapihi surya. He compared this way, and asdhatu atat kapyasam, that asdhatu is, you know, expansion, expression, two, both way you can speak. And Lakshman Deshi wanted to speak this way, that we cannot give this kind of dirty example. On the contrary, we can say this way, that sun god can suck water, drink water, so is Kapi, Surya, And by His mercy, I mean in the morning time when sun rises, then by His mercy, then lotus flower can express His total beauty. In full blossom, He can express. This example is very, very nice. So we can say this way, that lotus, the beauty, the lotus eyes of Supreme Lord is just like the petals of the lotus flower. When the lotus flower express in full blossom at the time of sunrise, this is very, very nice example. This way, Jadavacharya was very angry because he was insulted this way. So he spoke, this is not actually as, you know, this is actually secondary. As it is not actually main, you know, example, main. So this way he was defeated repeatedly. So now he wanted to make a plot, conspiracy to kill Lakshman Deshikh.